I got a great question on the website the other day. It said, why do first base coaches always carry a stopwatch? Most importantly, I want to get the pitcher's time from his first movement to when the ball hits the catcher's glove. So that gives me an idea how long it takes from that pitcher's first movement, the second he starts to go home, to when it hits the catcher's glove. Okay. The second reason I have that stopwatch is to time the catcher's throw from home to second base. All right. So now if I know these two times, I know exactly, not exactly, but on average, how long these two, this pitcher and this catcher combination, how long it takes them to throw the baseball down to second. So now if I know if I'm a good coach, I've got all the times on average that my guys can steal from first to second base. So I know how long it's going to take them to get there. If that number is lower than what the pitcher and catcher combo can throw down a second, I know that I've got a pretty good chance, if my guy gets a good jump, to steal second base. Okay? So that, those are the two main reasons, coaches, especially in the big leagues, you'll see coaches having stopwatches. That's the main reasons. Another reason could be getting the hitter's time to first base, although that's more of a scout's perspective, or what he's going to be doing is getting a hitter's time after he makes contact with the ball running through first base. But some coaches may need to know that and try to find that if it's a new player or something. So that may be another reason. Coaches, I've got two suggestions for you. Players, I hope that answered your question. Coaches, definitely take a day or a, 30 minutes or so and get your all of your players' average times stealing second base. So have them have a fake pitcher out there doing picks and pitching to first, or pitching to home and doing picks to first, and give them a true and honest lead, and have them try to steal the bag. Obviously you don't even need a throwdown in this, just have them go through the bag fully and get their times. Maybe get them to do it 5 or 6 or 10 times and get their average speed, so you know exactly what your guys are capable of stealing that bag in. Okay, on average. And then you could do your math and see what the pitcher-catcher combo is and see if it's a good idea for your players to steal in a certain situation. So that's my first suggestion. The second suggestion is you need to get a baseball stopwatch. This stopwatch is designed specifically for baseball. Okay, it keeps mile per hour for the pitcher, how fast he's throwing, and it can be used on a little league field, 46, 50, 60. You can set it to any number you want as far as feet, distance, and it keeps the mile per hour. It also keeps pitch count, and it can keep the time from the catcher to second base's throwdown, all in one function. That's one mode, okay? That's just one mode right there. You could also separate those modes. So you can do pitch count for your pitcher home and away. So let's say you're inner squatting or you're playing another team and you want to keep the opposing team pitcher's pitch count. It also keeps the balls and the strikes of the pitcher. So you're adding it up, 10 balls, 5 strikes, and then it shows you a total of 15. And then it shows you 10 and 5 as balls versus strikes. So you can keep your pitcher's pitch count and the opposing team's pitcher's pitch count, balls versus strikes and a total, which is great. That's probably the biggest reason I use the stopwatch for. It can also do the umpire mode. So umpires, this is great for you or coaches if you're keeping track of the outs and balls and strikes in a game. It just goes, tallies up strikes, tallies up balls. If you get 3 strikes, you get an out. It puts a tally mark, keeps you through 3 strikes. So it's very accurate too. It goes to the 100th of a second. So you got, for the 60-yard dash, it's a great timer. For home to first, it's a great timer as far as running. So I definitely suggest not buying a regular stopwatch, but buy a baseball-specific stopwatch. And this one is the best one you can get. So I'm going to leave a link down below. You can get your stopwatch there. Guys, I hope I answered your question.